Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. You know guys, I don't have a finished doll project today to show you. I'm still working on my another holidays slash winter special. Here it is, by the way, the head. You can see a little spoiler. I have finished her face already and I'm working on her body and accessories right now. So I don't have a doll video for you today, but I thought we could debunk some viral videos. Every time I see some nonsense, or maybe not a nonsense, but something that would be interesting to try, something I don't know if it would work. Every time I save this doll life hacks in a special map, and now you know, I see I have already something about 6-7 life hacks that we could try today. So today is another debunking video. You really loved the previous one that I've uploaded, I don't know, maybe 2 months ago or something like this. So I hope you're gonna enjoy this one today as well. I have prepared here a couple of doll heads, all kinds of different supplies here and there, both especially for this debunking experiment. So I have here my tablet. We are going to watch these videos together and then we are going to repeat this experiments, or in certain cases maybe we'll not even repeat them. I will just immediately explain you why these things are not gonna work. So let's debunk today. And the first life hack I actually wanted to try in my first debunking video, but I didn't have all the supplies needed then. Now I've bought everything and today we will finally see, test if it's possible to dye doll hair with food coloring. Honestly, I really doubt about it. First of all, you know, this is food coloring. It's not that permanent. It's supposed to, you know, go through our body, go out and leave no trace. And doll hair, it's a synthetic material. It's a synthetic fiber. And there is no way, in my eyes, how food coloring supposed to dye doll hair. Like, if you see food coloring permanently staining synthetic material or like plastic pots in your kitchen, better throw this food coloring away and don't consume it as a food, because I don't know, it's a dangerous material. But anyway, let's take a look at this video. So they take water, cold water, I suppose. They take some food coloring, blue color, indigo blue. They take a Barbie doll. They dip it into this mix. Then they put it in a kitchen towel. And then they have a completely different Barbie doll. Wait. A second ago, they had a blonde Barbie with just a little bit bluish hair, like just discolored water soaked in, made the hair wet. And now they show me this doll with this purple hair and they tell me that this is a result of dipping this blonde Barbie into this bluish mix. No. So this is actually the second reason for me to doubt about this trick. First of all, I don't believe that food coloring supposed to do something like this, stain synthetic fiber. And second of all, I don't see it working in their life hack as well. But anyway, we're here for science and let's try this life hack. Let's see how it's gonna work or not work. So I have prepared here 2 glasses with water, and one we're going to dilute this food coloring, and another one we're going to use to wash off this color. Then we have the food coloring, but especially for this project, especially for this experiment, even though I don't believe it's gonna work. So let's try. Let's add this food coloring into water. I honestly, guys, have no idea why they dilute it. I would apply it pure. I don't know, it's not gonna work anyway. Diluted or not diluted, it's all gonna be the same, I believe. And imagine now it's gonna work and it's gonna be beautiful and I will be here, wow! But it's not gonna happen. So now we take the doll and we dip her hair into this mix. Thank you. I don't know, they say nothing in this life hack, how long I supposed to keep it in? I don't know, I will let it sit like for 30 minutes maybe or something like this. So, and this is where we've ended up 30 minutes later. Approximately nowhere we've ended up. So let's wash it off. And the doll hair looks exactly the same like before the experiment. You know, I would be really shocked if it worked. And if you apply it straight to her hair, you know, anyway, we have to try everything before we say that it doesn't work. So, I apply it like this to her hair, and I will let it sit also for 30 minutes or something like this. And when we wash it 30 minutes later, we see that absolutely nothing has changed. So this life hack has been 100% debunked, but there is a question, is there a way to dye synthetic doll hair? And the answer is actually yes, but for this you have to use not some food coloring, but you're supposed to use some special dye, special coloring that is made for synthetic fiber. For example, like this Reed Dye More, it works perfectly on synthetic wigs, for example, on synthetic doll hair, on all kinds of synthetic fiber. And you can see it on the packaging that it works for polyester, it works for nylon, and it works for acrylic. I don't know, let's try it probably now. It would be much more constructive, not just to debunk life hacks, but also to show kind of the correct ways to reach the end result they show you in their viral videos. So, let's try to dye doll hair using this Reed dye for synthetic fiber. So, and this time actually instead of using hot water or whatever water like in their video, we are going to use hot cooking water. So, I will go now to the kitchen to cook water. Be right back. And I fill in the glass with cooking hot water. Add some of this product, some of this dye. And then I dip the doll hair to this mix of dye and hot water. Just watch out because it's gonna dye her face as well. And if you keep it in a little bit longer, the color is gonna be more intense. If you dip it in just for a couple of minutes, it's gonna be just like a tint. I think it's enough. Now we're going to wash it off. It's better to do it in the bathroom, of course, but anyway, for the sake of the video, we're gonna do it in my studio. So, and you can see now that we've got a really nice pink hair color, just, I don't know, in 5 minutes. I didn't hold it longer in because, you know, we still have a lot of different life hacks to debunk. So in 5 minutes you get this really nice pastel pink color, even with the gradient, because this part of the hair is always a little bit more damaged and it absorbs a little bit more of the hair dye. So this is a nice result. The first life hack debunked, corrected, showed how it's supposed to go, and now I think we can move on to the second one. So the next life hack we're not gonna try, for some obvious reason you will understand in a second. But let's just enjoy it, because this is the most pointless life hack ever. Like, every step is ridiculous and the end result is also predictable, let's call it like this. So let's take a look, and in this life hack they're going to show you how to curl doll hair. So they wash it. Then they take Q-tips and they cut both of the sides. Then they cut also like the one side of the tube. So they make like an opening, yeah, from both sides. And then they use these sticks to curl doll hair around. And then they fix them with elastics. Like, okay, this is of course a working thing. But look where they've ended up. Look at this. Look at... I don't know. So, first of all, this is a waste of Q-tips. Because they took the entire packaging of Q-tips. Look how many of these sticks they needed to curl her hair. It's really the entire package. How many is here? 80 in mine. So yeah, they for sure used 50 here. Okay, the second thing. This is extremely bad for the ecology. This is plastic. I don't really know where they have found these Q-tips with plastic tube, with plastic thing. Because normally nowadays, they all have paper stick. All of the Q-tips that I have in the house, it's paper. And what if everyone uses this life hack? And what if 1,000 people uses this life hack? Okay, so wasted a package of Q-tips. Extremely bad for the ecology. You know, okay, maybe it's not extremely bad, but this is a waste. This is absolutely not needed. Then I cannot even imagine how long it took them to curl doll's hair like this. It's more than an hour. It's more than an hour, really. This is already an art project. Because really, you get tired when you do something like this. And then you basically have zero control over the curls. Like looking at what we see now, I can predict just some messy, half loose curls, somewhere more, somewhere less. Okay, let's continue. They're not done yet. They're not done yet. Then they take white glue. They mix it with water. And then they dip this doll hair into this diluted white glue. I don't know, should we tell them there are styling products on the market? There is like hair gel, hair spray, all kinds of, I don't know, liquids, special mixes to curl your hair, to style it, to fix it. Okay, if it's easier to dilute white glue with water, whatever. And then they start taking all off. Really. Yes, and this is what you get. This is exactly what I expected. So, they have wasted a box of Q-tips. They have thrown away lots of plastic after doing this thing. They've spent a couple of hours curling all this situation just to get this. And there are lots of other life hacks like this in this video. Like for example, in the very beginning, they have a doll with greasy hair. Yes, it happens sometimes. And they use baby powder to make it less greasy. And yes, it would work if they knew where to stop. Because for some mystic reason, they just keep applying. And in the end, their doll looks, I don't know, dirty and gray and just... It looks old before her hair looked new and now it looks old. I don't know. It's also a strange life hack. I think they're supposed to stop a little bit earlier here. Then the next one is approximately the same like we've debunked last time. They show us how to cut doll hair in a ponytail. But here is very funny how they show the end result. How they try to conceal it, like to hide it from us. In the previous video with doll life hacks, they've done something off camera and they showed it to us as a result of them cutting her hair in a ponytail. Well, they've done definitely something different. In this video, they don't lie to us, but they try to sell it to us as a working life hack, but sometimes you can see that it doesn't work like it should. Let's take a quick look. So, they make a ponytail, here is nothing new. They chop it off, you can see what will be longer, what will be shorter. So, they take it off and they show how beautiful it looks from the front. So then they put some hairspray on it to make it more flat, to make the front of this hairstyle look a little bit more decent. And yes, this is how they're happy about it. But look here, here. Here you can see, this is just a fraction of a second, but you can see how the back of her hairstyle looks. Is it a life hack? Is it a way to make your dolls better and prettier? I doubt about it. So this was another very useful life hack that would help you to destroy your dolls. And now let's move on to the next one. And the next one we're going to actually to try. And I already feel like I'm going to destroy one of my dolls in a couple of minutes. So let's go. Now we will see how they will remove Sharpie stains with a toothpaste. And you know, a couple of years ago, it was probably about 3 years ago, I've made a video here on my channel. I've tried all kinds of life hacks trying to remove stains from some Sharpie, from some marker of the doll's face. I've tried hairspray, I've tried perfume, I think, something like this, some fragrances, but the toothpaste? No, I've never tried it, so it would be very interesting. It would be like an extra chapter, an extra experiment added to that video. So let's see if it's possible to remove stains from a doll's face using toothpaste. I have no idea, honestly. Maybe yes, maybe no, but let's take a look at their video first of all. So they take just a regular Colgate toothpaste. We have no idea what kind of markers or Sharpie or what has been used on this doll's face. I don't know, we can try different kinds of markers. But let's try, I don't know, let's try. So let's take our doll with pink hair. It's, by the way, quite a pretty color and I like the gradient. But anyway, let's draw something on her face. And let's draw it on the back. Don't want to waste her face completely. This is a permanent marker. Let's take another permanent marker, like just to try. We have all kinds of stains on her face. And then I've got here the toothpaste, just regular Oral-B 3D white toothpaste. And let's see if this toothpaste is gonna do anything to this stain. Well, and very predictably, nothing is happening, really. And these are very fresh stains. Nope, I see absolutely zero result, honestly, guys. Okay, and what if we take just a regular marker, not a Sharpie marker? And then it goes off. Okay. I think I figured out how they made this video. They take just a regular marker. They draw it on a doll face. And these stains, yes, indeed, they easily go off with toothpaste. But you know, the problem is that you don't really have to use toothpaste to remove stains like this. You can perfectly use, for example, where it is, some rubbing alcohol. Here we go. So you see, in this life hack, they have used toothpaste to remove something that can be removed actually without toothpaste as well, just with some, I don't know, with some fragrance, with some rubbing alcohol, with some nail polish remover, basically with anything. But is there a way then to remove real 100% permanent stains of rubber doll faces? And actually, yes, but for this you need to have a face cream. It doesn't have to be the same brand and name, But it must have this benzyl peroxide in it. I don't know how to pronounce it right, but something like this. But this is actually the product that can kind of bleach rubber faces, and it really removes, wipes off all kinds of staining. How to use it? I will show you now parts of my old video where I experiment with it. So you have to apply it to the stains on a doll face. Then we cover it with a kitchen plastic. And then we warm it up really for a couple of hours. I keep it under a lamp, just a lamp that warms up. You can also use a hair dryer, but you will have to blow really for a while in this situation. And then after a couple of hours, you get really completely clean face. The problem is that it can even bleach too much. It can bleach the actual rubber color. But you can always use some acrylic paint or soft pastels to, you know, like to match the color tone. So this is the real, the working way to remove stains from doll faces. You must have something like this, and this is actually cream or gel against acne or something like removing post-acne scarring, something like this. So it's really a product that bleaches faces and rubber, that just bleaches everything. So you need to have something like this if you want to remove real permanent stains from doll faces. And now I want to take a look at a little bit more different kind of a tutorial, because it's a more professional one. If the previous ones were just content farms, you know, like the same videos with some unbearable music, just repeated the same life hacks from one video to another. In this video, it's a video of 6 minutes, and it's dedicated just to one thing. They show you how to make doll hair using yarn. Beautiful, fantastic. It's a very working technique, and indeed I use it myself. And let's take a look at this tutorial, because it's missing just a tiny detail, but this is the detail that is changing everything. So in the beginning, they do everything absolutely correct. They remove doll hair, they reroot it with yarn. Then they start brushing it. The only thing that I can notice is that they brush in this yarn just like it is. You see, it exists out of 3 threads connected together, and they just brush it like it is. And I always make it loose first, like disconnect these 3 threads that make a big thread, and then I brush it with the cat brush. It just goes much easier, much faster. But anyway, here they do everything totally correct. They brush it. Then they make it straight using a hot iron. I do it in exactly the same way. So then they cut the bangs, and making bangs on dolls, it's always a risky business, guys, really, trust me. And then they start styling the doll. They make it wet, they brush it, they cut it, they brush it, they cut it, they cut it, they brush it, you know, they do it all. And look, here it looks quite okay, but not perfect. I absolutely hate the bangs. I hate that the hair is like too big. It's all supposed to be much more flat. But what is going on 1 second later? We can see absolutely perfect flat bangs, perfectly styled. We can see absolutely perfect also flat hair here. And this is because they have skipped the most important step in the entire process. Like, okay, it's maybe not the most important, but this is really the finishing step that is turning your hairstyle from this into this. And the first one looks quite, you know, amateuristic. It's okay, but nothing special. And the second one, yes, it's a beautiful finished hairstyle. You know what they've done? They have covered this doll's hair with a kitchen plastic, and they let it sit overnight. Maybe they've applied a little bit of some hairspray or some other styling product, but this is what has happened here 1000%. They have made it flat. After this, they have a little bit more trimmed the bangs, and they have styled it like more perfect. You can see now what I mean, because I'm showing now some parts of my old videos, how I've done it on my dolls when I made acrylic yarn hair. And I'm showing you this very important step of making doll hair flat. It's really crucial for making short doll hairstyles. It's really crucial for bob hairstyles, it's crucial for all kinds of pixie cuts, it's crucial for bangs. I have no idea why they hide this information in this tutorial, because this tutorial looks legit. Yeah, it looks quite professional. This is like, in this video I don't see content farm screaming like out of this tutorial. But yeah, this is a pure misinformation. If you follow this tutorial, you will get quite a nice hairstyle, but not as perfect as on the final picture. So should we talk about clickbait in the end very quickly? Because, you know, when I was looking for some life hacks for this video, I've noticed really unhealthy amount of clickbait thumbnails. For example, take a look at this one. They're making a doll dress, a wedding dress, out of a roll of toilet paper. There is nothing like this in this video. There is no such a tutorial in this video. They don't show you how to make a dress out of a toilet paper. Then the next one is with a flamingo. I've clicked on it myself because I wanted to know how they managed to make such an amazing flamingo, floating flamingo, for a doll. Well, guess what? They didn't make it. They have just photoshopped the thumbnail and that's it. So, and this is all, of course, very demotivating, and for content makers and for you, for viewers. Because first of all, as a viewer, you might watch such a tutorial, you will 100% fail, and you will end up with the feeling that you have no talent, that you have no skills, that your hands, I don't know, are growing from a wrong place or something like this. But in reality, there is nothing wrong with you. You have just followed a tutorial that didn't work and you had no idea about it. Also, these thumbnails, clickbait thumbnails, are also very demotivating, disappointing, misleading for the audience, for the viewers. And this is, by the way, against YouTube rules. It's against YouTube rules. You can find it in YouTube regulations that you cannot use misleading thumbnails. You cannot put on a thumbnail things that are not in the video. So, but nobody cares. They still get millions of views, and that's why it also becomes very demotivating for creators, because, you know, our doll making community, we work a lot. Like, our videos, they're the most time consuming here on YouTube, probably. No, of course not the most, but one of the most. It always 10 days plus to finish up the project, and we almost never get insane views. Like, I do it already for 4 years, and just a couple of my videos have a 1 million view, cross this line of 1 million view. And other doll artists don't even have this amount of views. I'm still the lucky one here, you know, get decent, nice views, get the views that would let me, you know, do just this for my job. But if you see all these millions and millions and millions of views on this clickbait videos, of course you feel very demotivated. You feel like, whatever I do, it's never good for them. This is what is good for them, and something like this I cannot make. And that's why many creators, they are leaving YouTube, because it's very difficult to get, for example, even 100 followers, 1000 followers. It's extremely difficult to get if you start from zero. Meanwhile, content farms keep farming, keep earning billions and billions of views and billions of dollars. Really, I don't know. And meanwhile, YouTube is doing nothing about it. And by the way, Wikipedia says that in late February 2011, so it's almost 9 years ago, Google announced it was adjusting search algorithms significantly to provide better rankings for high quality sites, sites with original content and information such as research, in-depth reports, thoughtful analysis, and so on. This was reported to be reaction to content farms and an attempt to reduce their effectiveness in manipulating search result rankings. February 2011, and I'm still sitting here and debunking, getting mad, sad, frustrated, demotivated, and stuff like this. Anyway, Yeah, this is what we can do. This is what we can do. We can talk about it. You can report, by the way, videos that have clickbait or some, you know, not working life hacks in them. This is how we can help it go, probably, because for now the content farms keep farming and the creators keep struggling. But anyway, thank you so much for watching this video today. If you have any other life hacks that you would love me to debunk or to take a look at them, maybe they're super useful and working, please leave them in the comment. Just, I don't know, maybe don't leave the links because YouTube is gonna move them to spam. Just, I don't know, just write an idea like what you want me to debunk. And maybe, yeah, in a couple of weeks I'll make another debunking video if you like it, of course. Also, right, please in the comments under this video if you like these kinds of videos on my channel. The previous one was actually very popular, so let's see how this one will go. So guys, thank you so much for being with me today. It was a fun video for me to make. I was really here all day mixing something and experimenting. It was really cool. So, and if it was interesting for you as well, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes, of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and I will see you already very soon, next week Friday. 100% will be here with a new winter holiday special doll repaint video. It's gonna be a cool one, so I will go now edit this video and then I will continue working on my next doll. So thank you so much guys for being with me today. I love you, you know it. See you soon. Bye.